Welcome back again at GMTV 42 as we bring to you one-on-one talk with Honorable Austin Omondi Makamu, the director of BBI from Nyanza region, as we want to talk more about the BBI. So we want to define the meaning of BBI to some of the citizens who are not getting to understand what is BBI all about. So today we actually want to talk more about the BBI, and first of all, Honorable, we'll just start with the getting us to know what the meaning of BBI is.
I think my name is Austin Omondi Makamu. I'm the director of BBI Western Kenya region. BBI, the meaning of BBI is to build bridges within the wananchi wa Kenya. And the BBI is a good thing that people of Kenya should appreciate and support it. BBI has got so many things, 9 points. One is the government of inclusivity. The election body must be reformed. 3, devolution. The fund from 15% will go to 35% to 40%. Health department. We want now to implement the health department to have their commission, like teacher service commission, to help this health department. The health department has been devolved. But you know there's a problem of small strike for the nurses and doctors. Now we want the county government to remain with structures, infrastructures, and the payment and the need should be at national level. They have to make to build their own commission, like teacher service commission, to help us this mambo ya strike to pote. There's another thing, we have this devolution, their location for bursary for the education students should go back to the ward level for MCAs to give that bursary, because it is now a grassroots bursary level. It is not a county level. That is a good one. And what we are now appreciating for the BBI also, it is the government, the national government, the election 2022. Every county, every region will be represented at national level. There will be no war. After 5 years election, we see the people are fighting for the position at national level. This time now the BBI has allocated position, almost 9 of them. The president, the deputy, 2 prime minister, speaker, senate, speaker, national assembly, and chief justice. Now the regional will be represented at national level. That's why after 5 years people are fighting because of power. That BBI has now reduced everything to an equal opportunity. The employment, there is no need of 2 tribes employed in national level. All Kenyans will be employed according to their qualification. Now this BBI is a good thing. I'm encouraging our people to support it fully, and they should not argue about it. That thing must come to referendum, and our people must prepare for it after this budget of 2020. June budget, we will go to a referendum on August when we have received the money. Parliament, assembly, speakers. If a speaker is a woman, then man should follow. That is the gender. And these youths are being cuttered, because if we devolve fund from 5 billion now to 35%, that is 15 billion. Their shares of 30% at county level, they will get now jobs. The youth, I just encourage them to go to polytechnics, these training vocations, to be trained. Then they will be taking tenders from county government for them to be empowered, because the money is now coming more. They should prepare and go. Everybody should be trained. Like me, my another qualification is I'm a plumber, a very senior engineer. And if I want to do any tender or drilling water in county government, I'll just go there and apply. Then I'll get the tender and I'll employ youth as an engineer.
What is the government doing to make everyone get the copy of this BBI report, so that they can get to understand what the BBI contains, like every detail, so that they don't be left behind on what is going to happen?
I think the committee of experts has been gazetted and they are going round. We as a politician, we are mobilizing. We start with Kisii in Nyanza region. We went to Kakamega. Last week, this weekend, we were in Mombasa. Next weekend, tutakuwa Kitui. We are doing the mobilization. At that time, the experts are now taking the views from wananchi. When we are moving, the committee of Yusuf Haji are taking responsibility for those things, and we are encouraging MPs and ward MCAs to go back to their grassroots. After going around to sensitize wananchi, they will produce this BBI Pekini books to the people.
Oh, thanks, Honorable. So, if I may ask, like, we have been having got many cases of election after year in, year out, when we have got the election process. So, how is this BBI report?
No, the BBI has catered for that election. We have what is called IPPG, okay. The Interparliamentary Group of this thing called the party, inter-parties parliamentary group, will cater for that election. Like these people are elected, Chebukati, were elected by the executive. Yeah. They were to support the executive side, not to support Kenyans' vote. Yeah. Now that thing will be automatic after referendum. The IBC will be disbanded, and we shall appoint a new IBC commission to conduct election of 2020. Under the party inter-party group, every party will take its representative to that IBC committee. Okay. If there is a problem, the party representation will blow the whistle. There is something being rigged here. And if you leave the IBPs to be appointed by executive, they just announce the executive as the winner, and people will fight.
Yeah. So, if I may conclude, what is your advice to the people who are watching outside there on their take on the BBI, and what you can advise them to do at this moment where some people are still confused on this BBI report thing? So maybe you can tell them something that they need to get so that they don't get themselves confused about the BBI report.
You know, if you are a leader as MCA, MP, governor, presidential candidate or prime minister, you are there to lead the people. And if your leaders are talking, they are talking about BBI, they are telling you what to do. You elect them to lead you. Yeah. And they must come with something which they lead you, you will get something on it. What we are doing, if Raila mesa soma, Raila ndio baba, and mesoma, mesema that thing, handshake, uhura mesoma, wa mesema it is good. We are just bringing those things for formality. But they'll get the papers. The one inch will get their books. They will read on it. But the final reading is Raila. And there's nothing like that. We are only to support what Baba say. Yeah. But for the people like MCAs, let them bring those papers and make some groups at their ward level, sub-location level. And then they talk about it the way I'm doing it now and release those books for the one inch to see them. They will do comparison, but the final reader, all the final reader is Raila Amolo Odinga. Baba kisa sema everything is okay.
So for the BBI report to be passed, what does it need? Like the number of leaders in the parliament, how many numbers of the governors, or does the BBI report need, or which process is it going to go through so that it gets to be successful?
Oh, you know, this time we have to go around 47 counties. Yeah. We have to meenda tatu. Tulikuwa Kinyanza region, tutaenda region, not even 47. Yeah. We'll just be moving in the region. The province, 8 provinces. Yeah. Instead of 47, we'll go to 8. We have tumeenda tatu, we are remaining with 5. Yeah. After that, now the committee of experts led by Yusuf Haji will now get the points. Then the expert will now start drafting what the wananchi are talking about, the way you are seeing in Mombasa, they need injustice, land issues. Now the expert like Yusuf Haji are taking points. They are drafting it now. After that, after going around 8 region, we will just sit down and give the expert time to draft it and take it to assemblies. Then the assembly will, 24 counties, 24 assemblies, they will pass it. Then we take it to Parliament. Parliament will just approve, but it will come to referendum. Because this constitution about position at national level, like Prime Minister and the rest, devolved fund should go to referendum. It cannot be amended by Parliament. Because Parliament, you can just stand up at the morning hours and then you dismantle the constitution. We need the rubber stamp of the one inch. That's why we'll go to Parliament. After that, we will pass the budget, June. Then we'll get a location for referendum. after June, July, then referendum, itakuwa August by 10th. We go for a referendum. After referendum, we now have the document. We now prepare for election.
Thanks, Honorable Austin Makamu wa Makamu. That was one-on-one live with the director of BBI from Nyanza region. Thanks to everyone who is watching this show, and we'll bring you more shows on GMTV 42 every Saturday and Sunday.